permission, I'd like to make some remarks. First of all, I thank you very much for inviting me to this ceremony celebrating excellence in your community. I am delighted to be here with you to attend this dinner, that with all its pomp and circumstances, but I'm also here to listen and hear and learn about your aspiration and the ideals you want to establish after the events of this dinner. I'm really pleased to be considered, and really flattered to be a guest of honor among this distinguished guest and fellows here, among the inaugural winners of the 2014 Bikila Award in Professional Excellence in Community Service, and particularly too in recognizing students for academic excellence as well as leadership potential. I applaud the winners for their commitments to excellence and for the great example that they have set for you, and particularly for the young children and students among you. I commend the leadership for your vision and thoughtfulness and for caring enough to invest your time and resources in establishing an event such as this program, and particularly a culture for recognizing excellence amongst you. It's wonderful in any society or any community to have a culture of recognizing excellence. By recognizing the best professionals and great leaders in the community. But when that culture of recognition includes honoring the youth in any way, and particularly in academic excellence and leadership potential as you do here, it is a particularly wise investment that is likely to accrue great and unending dividends down the road. I have no doubt that what you started tonight will greatly inspire and motivate these young boys and girls as they move forward. What they may see and hear tonight will ignite a spark of motivation for excellence in them. Even though I fully recognize that I'm also certain that the foundation for their character, for their personal spirit, is already in the upbringing that they have, that you set as an example as parents of these children, as teachers in their school, as adults in their neighborhood, because it takes a village. I want to mention one particular thing that I would like to draw your attention to, without being insulting of the country and native country that we all love. For those of us who raised family in North America, it has been a great blessing for our children to have been exposed to the value of reward and recognition. I say so because the Ethiopian culture, as great that it is in many regards, does not reward and recognize excellence. I think tonight's event, the recognition of Dr. Tafaradegafe, should bring that to heart to all of us. An individual of the caliber of this kind of achievement and leadership for decades in the country had not received this kind of recognition that you bestowed upon him tonight. The culture in our country, in our native country, often emphasizes punishment, denial, and sacrifice. Recognitions in Ethiopia or in places like that, when they do take place, belong to the privileged few, and often based on family lineage and descent, not in professional excellence or community service. The only heroes we celebrate in Ethiopia are war heroes, and God knows we had far too many wars in Ethiopia. That's why I find it so fitting that you chose to name your award after Abdullah Bikila. He was indeed the first non-war hero that we held up and celebrated in Ethiopia. True to his name Bikila, for those of you who don't speak Oromo, Bikila means sprite. true to his name, he came out, sprouted out of nowhere to become the first Ethiopian Olympic gold medalist and to eventually be celebrated as a national and international hero. And he did it, as you saw the footage tonight, in the marathon, the biggest, most historic and enduring sport in the Olympics. He also did it in the most dramatic fashion by running most of those 26 miles bare feet. Uncharacteristic for an Ethiopian, heroism was not in his family lineage. His success could neither be explained in the quality of training facility or not maybe totally true to the coaching that he received. It was just a historic birth of the greatest marathon runner in the history of mankind. And to show that this was no fluke, as you heard tonight repeatedly, he repeated his epic 1960 performance in Rome with a tantalizing run in Tokyo 4 years later. When the physical challenges with injuries became great and he had to pull out halfway into the Mexico City Olympics in 1968, he willed his understudy, Sergeant Mamo Wolde, to go on strong and win it for the country. And as some of you remember, Mamo won, giving Ethiopia a 12-year reign in Olympic gold medal, a feat that had never been repeated since. I hope that the youth of this community take this to heart. The legacy of Abdullah Bikila, the man your parents have chosen to venerate by naming this award after him, is that he showed the world that through hard work and discipline and brute determination and will, anything is possible. Your parents may not be marathon runners, but they too, I bet many of them had challenges that they had overcome to give you the opportunity of going to school in a country such as Canada. This is a great lesson from your parents' native country to draw upon as you face challenges in the future. The second lesson from tonight's event is that here in Canada, in your adopted country, this community respects and honors people who excel in their professions, serve their communities, and embolden the human spirit. And your own parents are leaders, good citizens, who have chosen a great cause to be a force of good in their community by creating the Abdullah Bikila Award that you may continue to celebrate annually. Finally, please allow me to speak briefly about the country that we all left behind. I know that your native country may be distant and out of sight, but not fully out of mind. Our daily grind at home and work occupies all of us fully, but we each spend considerable time thinking about the critical issues that face Ethiopia. We each have causes that we want to advance. For some, our professional life is directly connected to events and programs that take place in poor nations. I consider it a blessing that indeed what I do daily in teaching, in research, in technology development, and in policy advocacy are all connected in some way and make small contributions to programs in developing countries such as Ethiopia. Among the many avenues that I have had to contribute, I'm particularly focused on opportunities in human and institutional capacity development. I believe that there is not a great way to impact development in poor nations and contributing to the strengthening of its human and national institutional capacity. Like most countries of the developing nations, Ethiopia does need to expand its educational opportunities for all. The progress that has been made in primary, secondary, and tertiary education in Ethiopia in the last few years have been significant and splendid. In the last 10 years, large numbers of schools and colleges have mushroomed in all corners of the country and students have enrolled in great numbers. The positive of that is poor children from rural Ethiopia had gotten opportunities of education today. That's the good news. The bad news is deteriorating quality of education. The lack of well-trained teachers and professors to produce quality professionals with skills. Additionally, the government continues to be the sole employer as private sector employment is meager at the moment. Graduates may be bright, but they are not well trained and without marketable skills, and hence unemployment is very high, and many don't have gainful employment. The biggest aspiration of young people in Ethiopia, and I'm sad to say in many African countries today, has become immigrating to other lands in search of better opportunities. In particular in Ethiopia, compensations in the country have not grown relative to inflation and are among the lowest in the world. As a result, professionals have not been able to effectively serve the poor in their nations. Employees have become more mobile and transient, and the chances for strengthening vital institutions in the various sectors of the economy have been dismal. There is an apparent decline in strength of local institutions in many areas, and particularly in the agricultural sector that I know a little more about. I consider this to be an area of support that the nation would need, increased support from governments, from foundations, and even from the diaspora. I have made this an important area of focus for myself, and spend considerable time in advancing this cause for Ethiopia as well as other poor nations. I share this with you not as a brand list, but to solicit your support and advocacy in this vital area that our native country needs. So finally, let me wrap up by thanking you once again for the kind invitation to join you in the historic event and this lofty cause of celebrating excellence in your community. Thank you, and God bless.